Welcome children. Today we are going to start the second part of angles. Yes, in previous part whatever we have discussed, can you remember? Yes, tell me what are the main things we have discussed over there? The first thing was we have discussed about that part of the revolution when we are talking about a revolution, that means we are going for a circular path. Yes, that means we have take the example, suppose that hour hand of a clock is moving from any number to any other number. Yes, or when you are taking a turn from one direction to another direction, where we have discussed about the four direction, north, south, east, west, all these things. And when we were doing this part, when we were was involved in this discussion here, on that part only we have discussed about the right angle. Then when the two right angle was there, that was considered as a straight angle. And when there were two straight angle or four right angle, which one was called as a complete angle. And complete angle means what? It was a complete revolution. And you can remember also in many of the places I have written that a complete revolution, that means one revolution which is equal to a complete angle, it was measured as in a degree, that was 360 degree. Yes, and the half of that complete angle, it was what? That was a straight angle, and its measure was 180 degree. And for a right angle, what is the measure? That is 90 degree. Yes, so you people are very much friendly with all these things. Let's come to the another part of the angle. Here, other than right angle or straight angle or the complete angle, what are the other angles we have? Yes, so when any angle is less than 90 degree, yes, it is possible greater than 0 but less than 90. Some angles are possible which is more than 90 but less than 180. Yes, it is also possible. Some angles may be more than 180 but less than 360. We will get this situation. Yes, na? Okay, before I move to that part, let me tell you, when you are getting the angle, if you are getting the movement of a ray from an initial position to an terminating position, but suppose one ray has not moved at all, that means from its origin, if this is the origin, this is the ray we have, it has been originated, this is the initial position of this ray, and there is no revolution for that one, what will be the measure of this angle? Yes, tell me. That will be called as 0 degree. Yes, it will be 0 degree. That is also one angle. Yes, now, and when we are getting the movement, when that movement of that ray was, suppose it has started journey from, this is the initial position, I am coming back, I want to give you the recap of that one. This is the initial position, and from that initial position it had completed one right angle. Yes, that one was one right angle whose measure was 90 degree. In this case, that movement you have got, that revolution you have got, it is the 1/4 of the complete revolution. Yes, okay, when this, if this is the one situation, this is the first situation I am talking about where it was 0 degree. This was for a right angle. When this ray, if it has start the journey from 12, yes, if it is 12 and it is come up to 3, here let it be, if I am talking about, let it be, take it 12 only, it is there only, it does not move anymore, so that was 0 degree I have drawn. And when it has been start its journey from 12 and move up to 6, so here what you are getting, you can, if you are checking this one, you will get two right angles. Yes, that is a straight angle. Yes, now if that hour hand of the clock start its journey from 12 and complete one full revolution, yes, from there it is coming back to that initial position. This is the starting position from which it starts its journey and complete it by complete revolution, that means in this case you will get a complete angle whose measure will be 360 degrees. So I can write here, this one was 0 degree, this one it is called 90 degree, that is a right angle, and here this is 180 degree, which is called a straight angle, and when it's complete a complete revolution, that is a complete angle, that means 360 degree. Now I think you people have remembered whatever we have done in previous one. Now you can move to your NCERT book, page number 93. Some try these questions has been given. Yes, from that your concept will be clear.
Here we are going to discuss about these three questions so that what we are going to start today it will be clear for you all. Let's come to these situations.
Have you read the first question? Yes, let me read it again. In this question you have asked the hour hand of a clock moves from 12 to 5. Yes, here I have drawn the same one. If it starts a movement from 12 and it comes to 5, yes, what will happen? Is the revolution of the hour hand more than one right angle? Let me check. Here on previous one, you might have seen that for a right angle, what we are doing? If it is turning up to 3 from 12, that was a right angle. So what it is? It is not at all a right angle. Yes, when it is coming up to 5, it is here you can see it clearly, it is more than one right angle because this much is the right angle. Okay. Is it a straight angle or two right angles? Let's check. If I take the dotted line up to 6, because we know if that hour hand travel from 12 to 6, we will get a straight angle. But it is not coming up to that. So what angle it is? Yes, this is a question. No? What angle it is? It is not at all a right angle. It is not at all a straight angle. Okay. Now come to the second situation. I will clear all the doubts. Wait and be with me. Come to the second situation. Here you have asked, what does the angle made by the hour hand of a clock look like when it moves from 5 to 7? Let me draw. I am going to draw the second clock. Yes, let it be. This is 12, 6, 3, 9. Now, here it has been given. It is 1, 2, then it is 4, 5, then it is 7, 8, then it is 10, 11. Okay, in this question you have asked if the hour hand is moving from 5 to 7. So let me point towards 5. Here is my hour hand. And if it is moving from 5 to 7. Yes, again you come to your question. Here that hour hand is moving from 5 to 7. You can see it is coming from 5 to 7. That much only. Now you have asked, is the angle moved more than the right angle? See, is it equal to right angle? Now I want to give you one small concept about this one. If you don't know how to measure this angle, but you need a clear concept. Okay, see, come to my previous clock. Here you have seen that when it is moving from 12 to 3, in between you are leaving another two number, 1 and 2. Two number you have left in between. So that gap you have left, 1, 2, 3 gap you have left. Yes, then only you are getting one right angle. But here you can see only two gaps you are getting in between. So what you have understood, it is not at all one right angle, or it is there is no chance to be more than one right angle. So here the movement was from 5 to 7. Okay, now come to the third situation has been given in this question. Here draw the following and check the angle with right angle, that is RS tester, means it is right angle tester. Here the first situation has been given. I'm coming to question number 3. In first situation, it has been given going from 12 to 2. Okay, go for that clock. I think it will be visible to you all. Yes, here the movement has been given from 12 to 2. So I am only drawing this much. Here, this is the center. So that our hand starts its journey from 12 and it is coming up to 2. This much only. First situation, this is 12 to 2. Okay, now second situation, it has been given from 6 to 7. Yes, this is my clock. Here we have 6 to 7. Yes. So, if it is starting its journey from 6 and coming up to 7 only. Yes. This is the situation, it is coming from 6 to 7. That much only it is moving. I am putting an arrow so make it clear for you. That arrow is showing that movement. Now in third situation, it has been given from 4 to 8. Yes, again let me draw that another clock. Here you have asked for 4 to 8. So it is 4, 5, 7, it is 8. Yes, this one is 4 and this one is 8. Now in the last point, here it was 6 to 7. This one is 4 to 8. And last one 2 to 5. So let me draw the another top. And I will explain all these points. This is starting from 12. Then it is 6. It is 3. So it is 9. There is the center. We have to go for 2 to 5. So it is 1. It is 1. 2. Then it is 4. It is 5. Showing it is moving from 2 to 5. Let me draw the our hand. From 2 it will come up to. It will come to 5. Yes, that much more. Okay. Now, see. It is 2. 2. Here, in first case, I have told that it was asked, is it completing one right angle or is it more than one right angle? My answer was no. It is not one right angle or not more than one right angle. It is less than one right, sorry, it is more than one right angle but less than one straight angle. Here you have asked that is the revolution of the hour hand more than one right angle? For that, yes, we will write, yes, it is more than one right angle. Yes, when it was equal to one right angle, if it was coming up to 3 from 12. So here if it is going up to 5, that means it is coming more than one right angle. That part is over. Okay, so that one also we are coming here. Next point you have asked if it is moving from 5 to 7. Here we have seen it is less than one right angle. So for that one my answer will be, it is, you have asked more than one right angle. So here my answer will be no. No, it is less than one right angle. Okay, in the third bit, I have drawn all these. Now you tell me, is it one right angle or how many right angle you are getting? Again, it is, I can see that it is less than one right angle. Yes, it is less than one right angle. Here also you can see, this is also, for second bit, this is also, it is less than one right angle. Yes, here also you come to bit C. Here you can see, in this case, if it was coming up to 7, it was one right angle. But when it is coming up to 8, it's become more than one right angle. So here you can write more than one right angle. Okay, now the last situation, here you can see if it is coming from 2 to 5, here what you are getting, that one you are getting that it is completing one right angle. So here we can write equal to one right angle. Okay, now which one is equal to one right angle, it is okay for us. But our question is, when it is less than one right angle, when it is more than one right angle, what we will tell all these things. Okay, so for that, when we are getting that revolution of that hand, which one is less than one right angle, it will be called as acute angle. What you will tell? It will be called as acute angle. So when the movement is less than one right angle, yes, so acute angle, which one, when it will be called an acute angle, if it is less than 90 degree means one right angle. Yes, when it is less than one right angle but more than 0 degree. So this one will be called as acute angle. Now when we are getting more than one right angle but less than two right angle, that means one straight angle, so that one will be called as obtuse angle. When we will tell this one obtuse angle? When it is more than one right angle but less two right angle also we can write, or a straight angle. That will be called as one obtuse angle. Now, other than these two, we have another type of one angle, that is called reflex angle. Which one will be called as reflex angle? Okay, let's come to that reflex angle. You will get this situation also when we are looking for, okay, let it be, if I am drawing one triangle, I am giving you the situation, sorry, when we are going for a clock, where let it be one clock has been given, where you have asked, let it be this is 12, this is 6, this is 3, this is 9, 1, 2, 4, 5, 7, 8, 10, 11. Okay, if I am starting the journey from 12, yes, and after a rotation of 3 right angle, I am coming up to 9. Yes, I have taken that revolution from 12, it has finished its journey at 9. Clockwise direction. Here I have used the clockwise direction. You can see that's why I have put the arrow here. Okay, so when it is coming from 12 to 9, that movement, 12 to 9, here how many right angle it has been moved here? You can see. Tell me how many? Yes, you can see this is 1, up to that this is 2, up to that it is 3. So when that movement is 3 right angle, what we will call this one? That angle is being formed here. That angle will be here. What you are getting? You are getting 3 right angle. Yes or no? Its movement is you are getting 3 right angle. So that measure, when it is coming more than a straight angle, yes, but less than the complete angle, which is 360 degree, it will be told as, or it will be called as reflex angle. So this situation will be called as reflex angle. When it will be reflex angle? If it's measured more than a straight angle and less than a complete angle. Okay, this will be called as a reflex angle. Always keep it in your mind that when the measure of any angle you are getting, which is more than a straight angle, that means more than 180 degree, but less than the complete angle, means 360 degree, it will be called as reflex angle. Here I have shown you all the situation by drawing this clock. By the hour hand, movement of the hour hand, and in every cases, I have shown them that their movement is going on in the clockwise direction. Clockwise means it is following like after 12, it will come to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I think you people know. So, when we are going for a clockwise movement, and on that basis, I have told you what is acute angle, what is obtuse angle, what is reflex angle. Okay, let's come to the next part. Already we have discussed about the types of angles. Now we will learn how to measure the angle. So for measuring the angle, which instrument we are going to use here? Yes, we are going to use that protractor. You might have seen that half circular shape, this one, in your geometry box. Yes, so its name is protractor. How can you use this one to measure an angle? Okay, so before that, let me draw one angle. I am drawing here one angle. Yes, let me do it here. Angle means what? We know that two rays which has been originated from same point. Yes, I have drawn one angle. Yes, this is the vertex, that means origin of that. So, what we have to do for measuring the angle, what we will do here? This is the point, it will be considered as the vertex. That point we are going to put over that. Yes, and this line from where that number 0, that's counting, that base line will be 0. Here you can see in both the side of the protector you have 0. One side it is in the downside and another side it is on the upper side of that another number. Okay, so let's set the protector. How you will set? First you go for that vertex. Yes, that vertex should come to the center of your protector. See, I think it is clearly visible to you all. Follow this one. Here I have set my protractor like that, and baseline here for me, this is the zero. I will start counting from here. So what is the measure of this angle? So from where we will count from the number zero, which has been given here. So let's count from that. Yes, here I am getting that another ray. It is just marking over here. That means after it is 50 degree, then 55, 56, 57 degree. See, I am getting the measure of this angle, that is equal to 57 degree. Okay, so that measure of this angle, I can write it here, that is equal to 57 degree. See, what we have marked here, I have put one curved line. Yes, that means we are measuring this angle only, and its measure by the protractor, I have got 57 degree. How to write that degree? After writing the number, one small zero will be there on its overhead, like that. Okay, so this is 57 degree. Okay, so in this situation, you have start counting from right hand side. Here that zero is given. Okay, if I have given you one angle like that, how you can measure this one? I am giving you another situation. How can you measure this one? This is an angle I have drawn, and I have asked you to measure this angle. How you can do? Okay, for that also we have the solution. No need of turning nothing to do, only set your protractor. Yes, that baseline where that zero has been written, that baseline will be set on that base of this angle on one arm, any of the one arm. Then shade the vertex here, you can see at the center of your protractor. Yes, I think it is very much clear to you people. Okay, now you start counting. Where we will count? We will start counting from number zero. You can see from zero, if I am going 10, 20, 30, 40, yes, I am getting this one is 45 degree. You can see here I am getting 45. Yes, see, look at that. It is 45 degree. So in this case, the measure of this angle, I have got 45 degree. And when I have drawn these two angle, that angle should have some name. Okay, let's name this angle. I can name it like by 3 letters. Yes, it can be one angle, that is ABC, or I can call it CBA. Whenever you are writing any angle, you should use that angle sign and write this one as ABC. Okay, I can write it in different order also, but that order should be that starting and beginning letter can be changed, but middle one will always be in the middle. Okay, so here I can write CBA, or for that angle I can write only angle B. By only the vertex also I can indicate that angle. And measure of, here in short it is written like that, measure of angle B, that is we have got here 57 degree. Let's come to this angle. Let's name this one as XYZ. We generally name any of the angle by 3 letters, but we can call it by one letters which has been given as the vertex. So here name of this angle will be angle XYZ. We can write this one as ZYX also, or we can write it as angle Y only. Okay, so what is the measure of angle Y? That one is here we have got 45 degree. So whatever questions has been given in this part, I think you people can go with this. You may not have any problem. Okay, suppose you have given any as I have drawn these two, now you tell me what type of angles you have got. Yes, is it a right angle? Is it acute angle? Is it an obtuse angle or reflex angle? Yes, all the angles here, the two angles, both of them are acute angle. You have seen, their measure is less than 90. In both the cases, these are less than 90 degree. Okay, so how will look one obtuse angle? Let's come to that one. I am drawing one obtuse angle. Yes, this is the one ray. Here I am, this is the vertex I will take, and one angle I am taking on that side. One ray I am taking on that side. Okay, now I will measure this angle. Let's name this one as MNO. What will be the measure of angle MNO? Let's set your protractor. Yes, you can see I have set it where this is the vertex and the baseline. You must be careful for these two points. Now you start counting from the baseline. Baseline means zero. Here you see from zero we are counting, then measure what we are getting here. Yes, up it is the zero, then 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100, 110. Yes, I have got it here 115. So measure of this angle become 115 degree. Again I am putting this one, you see. I am putting that protector on that. Here I am setting the protector on that. And check this measure, it is coming exactly 115. It is after 110, before 120. So this is one what type of angle? This is one obtuse angle. Okay, but how you will find out any measure of that reflex angle? Okay, let me show you. I am drawing one reflex angle. Yes, for in reflex angle we cannot go directly with the help of that protector. I have to take one some different way for that. Yes, suppose this is the reflex angle you have asked to find the measure, and let me name this one as RHT. Here I have put the curve on that. That means I need the measure of that angle. So what we can do here, let's go for, because that protector have that measure of up to 180 degree, but it is beyond 180 degree. So what can I do? I can do one thing, one shortcut I can apply here. You can see I can make 180 degree. Yes, I have made 180 degree by that dotted line. Now what I will do, I will put my protector on that. That means whatever measure I will get, I will add it with 180. Yes, see, up to that it was 180. Already we know this one by that straight line. Now come to the more than 180, how much is remaining? That one I am going to measure. Here you can see what I am getting. Yes, go for a clear observation here. You see, what is the measure you are getting of that line? Here you can see you are getting 9. It is here, it is coming from that side. From 0 you start counting, you are coming up to 130. Okay, I can show you that one. It is clearly visible here. That one you are getting here 130, you see. So it is okay, hold on, it's just moving a little bit. Yes, yes, here I am getting this one as 130. See, from 0 I have counted, and already I have, for that much I have 180, and that much is 130. So there sum that is equal to, I am getting, this is equal to how much? Tell me. You are getting 310 degree. So the measure of, I can write here, measure of angle is, we are getting here 310 degree. And what type of angle is this? This is a reflex angle. Okay, so you people are clear about that measure. Here that measure of angle N was 115 degree. This was an obtuse angle. Here this one is an reflex angle, and that these two was example of acute angle. Yes, so let's try to solve the exercise. All the questions you people try to solve. Already you are very much free with this use of the protector. So let's come to that part.